Hello and welcome to Box 9 Live. This is our new variety talk show as we cover greyhound racing a little differently. My name is Gareth Hall and it's time to welcome in the team. And boy, what a team we have for you tonight, because obviously the highlight on the track will be the RSN 927 Sandown Cup, where some of the best days in the country will be doing battle. But some of the best days here are off the track as well. Trevor Marmalade's been on every big show this country has produced. Hey, hey, a Saturday. And also, of course, the footy show. Trev, welcome.
Well, not as big as this.
Oh, this is huge.
I didn't realise I was coming down to the Tonight Show of greyhound racing. Here we are. Have a look at this.
Are we firing? You're like the Larry Emder of greyhound racing now.
We've made it, haven't we?
Fantastic.
This is the biggest gig that I've ever had.
Mate, well, look, here I was thinking, oh, it's a chance to legally leave the house. So I won't pass it up. But look at this. This is unbelievable.
Now, there's 20 people here. Only 20. Can you count? Our next guest is a man that played 258 AFL games, premiership play at the Collingwood Football Club, All-Australian, Daisy Thomas. G'day, mate.
G'day, mate. Thanks for having me. Ruptious round of applause. Similar to what it would have been like round one if I had still been playing in front of a big crowd. But great to be here. Great to be out of the house. An apology off the top from me. I blamed my missus for shrinking my clothes. Turns out putting a suit on, I've just gotten fat. So, Natasha, I'm terribly sorry.
It was actually a little bit weird getting dressed tonight because I haven't been outside for at least 3 months.
Well, the golf came back 2 weeks ago, so I put the golf gear on and dead set accused her of shrinking all my golf attire. And then I've gone for the slacks tonight and the shirt, and it's none of it's fitting. So that one's
You're looking well.
Thank you.
And this man's from Showbiz Royalty. We all know him. He's one of the funniest men in the country, Marty Fields. G'day, Marty.
Absolute pleasure to be here. Thank you. It's wonderful. It's very unusual to come to a greyhound track and there'd be nobody here. Except
full stop.
And they test your temperature and you come in. It's unfortunately the same thermometer they use to test the dog, so I might need a beer to get the taste out of my mouth. But it's a wonderful night to get out. Beautiful night in Melbourne. Cool. Track conditions are firm. And looking forward to some great racing. I'm not an expert on greyhounds, but I am an expert on dogs. So if you've got any other kind of dogs that are running around out there, I'll be very, very good, a very good source of mail, Trev.
Well, when we have the Chevoodle race, you'll be into that.
I'm all over.
Okay, we'll get you tips for that.
Yeah, it's the lab cross.
When was the last time you were at the dogs, Trev?
This is my second time at Sandown Park.
Yeah.
When I was doing the footy show, the best thing about doing the footy show is that we actually had 5 months off in between seasons.
And you got paid for 12 months.
Absolutely, and the check just rolled in. So, but that couldn't go forever. One summer they decided they put me to work and they asked me to do a series of interviews for the cricket show. So I had 10 interviews. I did Warnie, went up to Sydney, had a beer with Dougie Walters, spent a day in a pub tab with Mark Waugh. Went up to Brisbane and went out on the boat with the great man Jeff Thompson, which was a lot of fun. And then had a night at the greyhound races, Sandown Park, here with Ricky Ponting.
And how'd you go?
Well, it was a great get because, I mean, you know, it's not exactly handy to town. And it was only 2 days before a test match. So we did the thing out here with Ricky, and at the end of it, I said, oh, mate, just fantastic of you to do this. Like, I really appreciate it. It's fantastic. We're so far from the city and, like, you know, 2 days to a test. He went, no, I would have been coming here anyway.
Mark Waugh used to do the same when he was over in Perth. He used to head over to the Gloucester Park Trots because he loved his harness racing. Obviously, Marty and yourself were in Hey Hey Saturday. How many times have you guys worked together?
Well, we were in every second week. Great Aussie Joke was every second week. Trev was in every week, but they used to put him, so he actually wasn't there much because they used to send him to these. One of my favourite lines in Hey Hey, it's all happening here in Tumut.
Well, in actual fact, before I was on camera at Hey Hey, I worked there as a writer. A creative consultant was the title, which is like a writer, except you never pick up a pen, right? Because,
well, the show's not scripted, so you don't really write anything.
It's more about sitting around going, oh, Daryl comes in wearing a funny hat, or he's dressed as a banana, right? And that's an idea. Or, you know, we'll put celebrity names on our head and we'll guess. So anyway, one of my jobs as a writer, we used to have the Great Aussie Joke segment. Mm-hmm. And of course, you know, people used to send in jokes from all over the country. And I actually lived opposite Maury.
That's right.
At the time, Maury Fields, the great man, Marty's dad, of course. And I used to come home with like a stack of folders full of jokes that had been sent in And by the time I'd gone through them all and put the ones we could use in a folder, I used to walk across the road and slide them under Murray's door.
So not too many clean jokes.
Those gags we had to choose from were ones you'd actually filtered out. They were the best. Dad and I used to sit down together and go through the folder of the gags sent in by people all over Australia. Oh, look, I don't think people have a bit of a grasp on what you can say on television. With some, oh, my word. Some shocking, shocking jokes. But they were the best. They were the cream, were they?
Apparently so. Well, and I used to say to him, how am I going to do this? I got thousands to go through. Just read the punchline, son.
Yeah, exactly. And read the tag, mate. If it's funny, it'll work backwards.
Joining the team as well is James Vandermart and also Sarah Allardyce. And they're our experts today because we don't have a clue. The Punters Club, there's still a couple of minutes, I think, to register for the Punters Club. It's only around $10 a ticket. And hopefully we can make you a little bit of money. Hello, Sarah. Hello, James.
Hello. Thank you, Gareth, and welcome to everyone tuning in online. It's really it's a different Sandown Cup this time round, but we're all for it. So a great race four. So the all-time favourite, well, James' all-time favourite. He loves Simon Told Helen. So Simon Told Helen came in beating Tigalong Tonk. It was 1-5-2 from 7.
Yep.
So James is our race caller, resident tipster, whatever name you want to give him.
Little bit of everything I do around here.
Little bit of everything. So James will give you some tips for the next race and some details on the Punters Club as well, James.
Yes, indeed. In that last race, Simon Told Helen, how good is he? I mean, he missed the kick tonight. He probably missed it by two lengths, but his turn of foot to go underneath of Tigalong Tonk and Jack's Bale, he just monstered his opponents. It was so impressive to watch. But kicking on to race number 5, of course, my tips as well as George Farouk, they've been co-mingled to create tonight's Punters Club. So let's hope between myself and George we can find a few winners. This next race, I thought 8-3, 6-4 were the testing material. Here's Tears is obviously going to be a massive contender. He's drawn really well on the outside. He's got that loping style, and if he gets a clear run at them, I Nancy last week was just an enormous run. She powered home. It was her first look here at Sandown under race conditions. I think, Sarah, this is a greyhound to keep an eye on. Look Fancy Nancy.
Good job. And just the Punters Club that we've got going on tonight. So
yes, $10 a ticket. Yep. Gareth, we're still selling tickets, I think, aren't we? We are indeed. So $10 a ticket, and we've got quaddies on already on the Punters Club. We're going to get that board up. Here we go. Look at that. Right on cue. The starting balance of around $2,500. First bet, we're going to have $200 a win on Look Fancy Nancy at $4.60. As you can see, there are three quaddies, one worth $600, one worth $504, and the other worth $180. So we've decided to go big with the quaddie. One tonight.
Fabulous. So if you want to join into the Punters Club, you just got to go to box9.com.au. Back to you, Gareth.
I just got to ask a question for James. Simon Told Helen, he's one of my favourite greyhounds. He reminds me of Daisy a little bit with his acceleration. How did he get his name?
Litter of greyhounds that were coming through, and I don't think any of the wives were aware of the greyhounds that the lads owned. And as it turned out, Simon, I think, eventually had to tell Helen, and hence the name Simon Told Helen. But they're still trying to work out who told Stevie, which is the litter brother. And as you know, Gareth, there was that great race a few months ago in the Great Chase when Simon Told Helen beat Who Told Stevie. And I think in the call I said, Simon Told Helen, Who Told Stevie, I'm Easy Boys, who happened to run third. So it didn't work out too well for me as a race caller, but it was a bit of a laugh anyway.
Now I'm going to give you a task too. I'm going to get Marty to think of a word maybe in race number 8 that you could use during that broadcast. Is that okay? Because he's pretty good. He's got a bit of...
Perfect.
Yeah,
as long as it's not going to lose my job. But RSN, no. You're pretty high up there, Gareth, so you'll be able to
you'll
keep
be
me
right,
in,
mate. Good calling, Jimmy.
Thanks, mate.
Thank you to James and Sarah. And we want you to participate and help us out because we'll be talking about some funny greyhound names. And we want your nominations, and it's pretty easy to help us out. Just head to the Facebook page, or you can tweet us at Sandown Dogs, or email at admin@box9.com.au, and we'll read out some funny names, Trev.
Is that right?
Yeah.
Okay.
You got a few up your sleeve?
Well,
a little later on.
Well, okay.
I'm looking forward to it.
Are they sending him in?
Yeah, hopefully.
Okay, well, I don't need him up my sleeve.
Hopefully as many as those jokes that I used to send to you all those years ago. Daisy Thomas, geez, you had a wonderful football career.
Thank you, yeah. I'm
Premiership sure, player.
I'm not going to disagree with you. Keep going.
What was your favourite moment?
First game is obviously a highlight, but winning the Premiership in the fashion that we did, obviously being a draw the week before and then coming out the week later, and I think time being able to properly soak that in, that was certainly the favourite moment, and probably not being called back to do pre-season this year.
Yeah.
Two of those are right up there.
Did you want to go on?
I thought I potentially could have. The footy I was playing was good enough, but as you know, I've always sort of just rolled with the punches and sort of rode life out a little bit, and for whatever weird reason I didn't go on, and then this crazy pandemic we find ourselves in has hit, and we'll have a look at the highlights of the play. Look at that, a regulation chess mark. You know, one of me many talents.
That was a highlight, because Scotty Thompson just gave you one in the rib cage.
Correct.
I actually quite enjoyed that.
And belt someone. But in this, you know, if I had played on, and would I have regretted, you know, having to do a pre-season and then the weird state of affairs it is, I probably would have. So everything sort of happens for a reason. I've always sort of lived by that mantra, and yeah, here I am at the Sandown Greyhounds when I thought I was going to be on the Amalfi Coast of Italy.
Yeah.
And Daisy, you played with Collingwood and then you played with Carlton. So I'm curious, was it better to play in front of people who'd lost all their teeth or lost all their hope?
50-50 by the end of it. When I went from Collingwood to Carlton, the Collingwood supporters started hating me. The Carlton supporters already hated me because I'd had a career at Collingwood. So I was universally hated for a fair patch there. So it wasn't the best experience, but it was nice to get some photos once I got to Carlton with a few people who weren't cashing gold checks and losing teeth, it was for sure.
Now, mate, you've had a bit of an off-season. You've wound up in the jungle. Not many people put weight on in the jungle. What's going on there?
Well, I was in the jungle. I lost the weight.
Tell us about the experience.
You found it, mate.
I'll run you through it. So I was obviously in the jungle 31 days. They told me to put a bit of weight on, sir, before I went on, because you get deprived of everything, no food. I lost about 9 kilos, put maybe 8 or so on, so I was still running at about playing weight when I came out. Was all pumped to go on this overseas holiday that I've just touched on. And then as I was about to book it, they closed the borders, they shut everything down, and my motivation levels and my want to be in some sort of look, as I thought I may have been at some point shirtless posting on Instagram, so went by the wayside, and I swung past every drive-through on the way home.
I haven't seen a lot of I'm a Celebrity, but it seems to be a show where they take people to the jungle and make them eat horrible stuff.
Yeah.
So what did you get to do?
Well, that was it. I don't really like snakes. I don't like sleeping outside. I don't really like strangers. And pretty much that's the show I signed up for.
Okay.
So I should have read
and
the
you
fine
pretty
print.
Much don't like your agent anymore.
Yeah, correct. So, and the term celebrity is pretty loose just between you and me, too. There's a couple of people I had to introduce myself to.
So did you make any lifelong friends in there?
It's funny you should say that. Miguel, the celebrity Spanish chef, I couldn't understand him. Still
isn't
can't.
He delightful?
He's an absolute ripper.
Beautiful.
And a few of the other people, but it's so bizarre. 31 days living in the jungle, doing strange things. You do become like a weird family. So we've all stayed pretty close. A good mate of yours, Billy Brownless.
Okay.
He was in the bunk next to me. He slept in these old man dad boxes. Yeah. So every morning I got to see Billy's balls, which is, again,
so is it all as we see it? Because like we heard stories about when Warnie was on, there was like, you know, there was a separate room out the back of the jungle where he could go out for a dart all day long. Was it as we saw?
Well, I'm obviously not of the celebrity that Warnie is. So I about day four, I was starving, I was thirsty, I'd done me bit, I'd done a challenge, I'd run off this treadmill at 1600 feet above a cliff, rolled into this little tok-toki and said, look, I've had it up to here, I'd love a pizza and a beer, like, just fill me up a bit, out the door, son, off you go. Yeah. So that was it. The only thing I got to eat in the next 3 weeks was 2 goat's testicles.
What was the worst thing you did there?
Well, the goat's testicles was right up there. One
because,
of them
because
on
three
plate.
Is too many and one's never enough.
Yeah, right. Because you get one at a party and then you're looking for the bloke with the tray. And they're always gone.
Correct.
If you got so you wait near the door.
If they call them prairie oysters, it's fine.
Yeah.
What do they taste like?
It was pretty gross. It wasn't so much the taste, it was the texture. And I dead said bit into the first one and it exploded on my face. So technically, a goat's junk is, Anyway, it was a good show. I was glad I did it. Onwards and upwards.
That's your story. You're sticking to it.
And they're saying, "How do you what? Give up showbiz?"
Correct. So there's one happy goat out there.
Maybe there's a chance for Trevor the gig next season.
Absolutely.
Absolutely.
They probably came knocking on your door before, Trev.
I need the warning room out the back.
Yeah. Hey, Daisy, what about playing football again? You would have had a few offers from some country clubs.
Oh, the cashies, they're gone, mate. They're gone.
Yeah, as I said, I'm doing it tough out here. Now, I entertain the idea. I always told my mates at Druin that if I was still fit and willing and able, once I retired, I'd go back and play a game with them. hoping, of course, that that was over many beers and they'd forget about it. Well, I reckon it was day one I got retired. They said, are you playing round one? So that was going to happen, which I was actually really looking forward to. I was going to go down to Tassie and play a game down there for a club.
So are you in like the Favola class and the... cash payment at the country club?
I don't know what he was getting, but I think people thought, because I still could have potentially played on, I was playing some good footy, that I'd want to go down and try my guts out. And I was pretty upfront and honest to these people on the phone. I was like, if you want someone to win your game, I'm not your guy. In your Gower Square, talk some crap to the people, the kids behind the fence, try and take a few hangers, a few left foot bananas. That's me. Yeah. So
see, I'm thinking the Gower Square is the last place you actually want to hang at those sort of games.
Yeah, no, that was me. I was, as you can see,
I'd be getting away from the crowd. 50. I'd be getting in the middle.
No, I didn't want, the last thing I wanted was some kid who was fitter than me and probably better nick than me showing me up.
Because that's the case sometimes when the big name AFL players are just retired, head back to the country club. Old Joe Blow out the back that said, well, I'll make sure I get Daisy Thomas. I'll give you one behind play.
Yeah, well, I would, I wouldn't have liked that too much, although... No. These sort of social distancing rules would have suited the way I played for 14 years, a metre and a half away from everyone. Would have been a good excuse for Mick Mouldiers not to spray me for not tackling.
Now, obviously Marty and I are sort of greyhound novices, but you've been involved. You've had dogs.
I've had a couple, yeah. Tear It Down was one we had with a couple of the Carlton boys, and I had our sporting...
Who was in that?
Mark Murphy, Cade Simpson, Bryce Gibbs.
Did it go all right?
It went all right. I think it won about 10 or so races.
Okay.
That's a big night.
Yeah. One of the... not on the same night. Very good. It won the first... So we were going like crap at the time. I think we were zipping five.
This is a Carlton, yeah.
This is a Carlton. We're flying out to Fremantle to play over there and they were going pretty well. The dog won. We flew out. We won. It raced the next week. We beat someone else. I think we strung three or four wins in a row. Each week the dog... ran and won, we ran and won.
Yeah.
So Bolts at the time was calling up the train, I think it was Lisa Rasmus, and telling us if we set it round every week. Didn't happen, and then we lost the next 10 in a row.
The next race.
One of my favourite stories,
gotta get to a race in a minute, we'll come back. But Marty's got to give the first tip, and you're representing a sporting club as well?
That is correct, I'm representing the Ringwood Football Club.
Yes.
Good club.
Beautiful bunch of blokes down there. Ricky George has rung us in on behalf of the Ringman Footy Club, and I reckon that they should jump on number 8, Here's Tears.
Okay. That's brother's called Superman.
Is that right?
Yeah, I don't know what he's... He's not bad. He's a Group 1 winner. He might get... Hopefully he gets the chocolates. I think he's the favourite.
Is he really?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, good luck to him. And, they can use the money down at Ringwood to build another ice skating rink. Lovely spot down there.
So we got some money on them, and they win a hamper and a gift prize. So let's head upstairs. He's James Vandermark for the call of race number 5 at Sandown tonight.
This race will take us into the Sandown Cup. Race number 6 on the program. Good luck if you're playing at the quaddy. Tap with the projected $100,000 quaddy pull here tonight. So they're loading up well. Race 5. Favoured Here's Tears. Drawn the outside. He was third in a heat of the race, the Sandown Cup last week. So they're loading up well, 7:15, and the last of them being placed in Look Fancy Nancy into box number 3. She was an eye-catching run on the heels of the place getters last week in a heat of the Sandown Cup. Green light, and the Cup Night stayers are ready. Stand by, set, away. Here's Tears began about third from the outside. First to go, Rajasthan, and he's going to cruise over and lead. Here's Tears a length away, and they're by 3 to Frankie J's Submission. A break of 3 to Banger, then Blue Shadows, and Look Fancy Nancy last, but starting to make a run. Under a lap to go, and Here's Tears was able to whip around and take the lead by a length and a half to Rajasthan. Last year's Sandown Cup champ starting to rally on the inside. They're by 7 lengths to Frankie J, Submission and Banger. The rest headed by Look Fancy Nancy, Blue Shadows. Rajasthan came back. Here's Tears again levelled up on the outside. They're by 3 to Frankie J. Here's Tears had taken Rajasthan, turning for home, and it's Here's Tears. He'll lope home and win it. Here's Tears got there by a length. Flashing.
Going nowhere in a hurry. You know, let's bring down the city song.
if I stuffed the name up already. Best band in town.
Can I just say hello? Add number 8 go.
Hey, brilliant.
Just
brilliant.
Got the well money done, for our friends at the Ringwood Footy Club, so they've got a hamper on their way.
Yep.
And also a $50 bet.
How did number
never
one
looked
go?
Like getting beat.
I had a quiet thing on number 1. It nearly chased it home.
The kind people out at Ringwood, you never heard someone cheer. So.
No.
Your hamper was dust at the 50.
Don't get a lot of hampers in Ringwood.
No. Do you keep on going on, and we got to switch it up? I think you're next, Trev. No pressure.
Okay.
Yep.
Yeah, all right.
Coming up shortly, Johnny Sadler's not far away. Looking forward to catching up with Johnny. And plus, there's some terrific giveaways as well. We'll be crossing back shortly with Jimmy Vandermark because he was going to update us on the Punters Club. Okay. Hopefully, we had that in the Punters Club. I'm pretty sure we would have, Daisy.
They're naughty.
Yeah.
I thought he tipped number 4, though. Didn't he have 200 on number 4?
We had it in the Punters Club. So
okay, beautiful.
Happy arts.
I had a bit of mail for vacant box. That's good.
Hey, we've missed sport. Have you missed sport, Trev?
Absolutely.
Yep.
Well, thankfully, racing's gone ahead. It's been...
Thank God for that.
Well, exactly, I have to say. And we're great for the participants, but also great just to have the release and not to have that thing where you're sitting in front of the TV just being bombarded with the same bad news.
Yeah.
I have to say.
And it was interesting watching the sporting news over this particular period. There's been a lot of, is it TikTok videos that the AFL players have been sending in? And it has been hard to take, but the NRL's back tonight. The Brisbane Broncos taking on the Eels, and football's not far away, Daisy.
No, it's not, which is fantastic news for everyone. Like Trev touched on it, it's amazing how much sport actually means to so many people, and until it's taken away, which I don't think we probably ever thought would happen, you realise that. So for footy to be back and give people something else to look at rather than me and David Warner and all other stupid washed-up, well, he's not washed up, but I am, sportsmen doing TikToks and doing silly dances. Are you on the tick?
It's crazy times. But we've had to actually basically everything. I mean, you know, who would have thought I'd be a teenage son to get in your room and play video games and do not come out? a comedian rings you up at 10 o'clock in the morning going, you want to go for a walk? And you go, oh, that'd be nice. Well, yeah, what has happened in the world?
You know? Exactly. Tonight, of course, rugby league going around for the first time. 300 million people watching it worldwide, which means the trending topic on Twitter tonight will be, what the hell's going on? 290 million of them won't know what the hell's going on.
Do you like rugby league,
Marty? I'm a big fan, yeah. I'm one of the ambassadors of the Melbourne Storm and love the game.
Yeah. Who's your favourite player?
At the moment?
Yeah.
God of rugby league. Greatest of all time.
It's amazing his career, isn't it?
Incredible.
He's the first rugby league player to play 400. And to do what he's been able to do, to have the success with the Storm, but also the success with Queensland too throughout his career.
Amazing. And like, you know, like he's nearly 60 now. I mean, he had a colonoscopy and an arrow in. Yeah. He's getting on. He's got a signed copy of the Bible. But he is a wonderful advertisement for the game.
Yeah.
Never any drama. That's the great thing about the Melbourne Storm, I've got to say. They don't have all the crap that goes on off the field. Bellamy, who's their coach, just runs a very, very tight ship, and they simply don't tolerate it. There's no transgressions. You know, like, okay, fair enough. Josh Adokar shot a gun, but that wasn't so much because he was trying to be a criminal. It's just that he's an idiot.
Yeah.
So, you know, who amongst us, when handed a gun, wouldn't shoot it?
And it wasn't at anyone. It was at a camp.
Exactly. It wasn't at anybody. They were in the middle of nowhere. Offenses.
And the sheer brilliance to post it on social media.
Oh, yes. Very clever. Him and Latrell.
What would have Craig said to Josh?
Oh, Craig probably would have said, do you still have the gun?
Daisy, what about your former teammates and the players that are playing the game at the moment? Have you been in conversation with them and how have they handled it?
Yeah, I've spoken to a fair few of them. I was sending them lots of photos of me playing golf and drinking beer and doing all the things they can't do. It's just so weird. Like, obviously, they've done a pre-season. That's the worst part. You look forward to round one, you get to run out, you get to do what you love to do. And then they got stopped and they had to do another pre-season by themselves. So I know most of them have been doing what they're supposed to do in terms of like the training and finding it quite difficult, because training by yourself or with one other person and expect to do a 14-kilometre session, I know you're a professional athlete, but it's it's hard to sell that to anyone, and especially not knowing when a start date was. So I think we've got Heath Shaw coming up tonight, which is going to be great because he could be fatter than me at this stage. It's going to be interesting. Wow. I could potentially end his career right here on box nine.
Well, mate, it's supposed to be your 10-year reunion for your premiership this year. What are you going to do? Are you going to be like on Zoom with lampshades on your head?
Well, what are you going to do? That might be the only way forward. It might be a 20-minute Zoom call because we had a few tight asses in that team, so I'm not sure they'll pay for the full subscription either.
It'll be interesting to see what the standard is like when we return.
Yeah, I think for the better, if you will, teams, your Richmonds, your Collingwoods, your West Coasts, who are, you know, as we touch on with the Storm, professional outfits, really well run, really well drilled, won't be such an issue because you won't have that doubt on anything and they just know their game plan inside out. Whereas some of the lesser teams, it could be a little bit interesting. And especially, you know, sending people up to the Gold Coast in the hubs, talking to you about it, Trev, you take away surfing, golf and chasing birds around there, that's defeats the whole purpose of going to the Gold Coast.
I'm pretty confident about how North's going to go. I mean, they're saying, oh, how are they going to go without any crowds there? We're going to smash
right,
it.
Like, right at home.
You need to ask Heath Shaw when we've got him on how they're going to feel about playing in front of bigger numbers. Because their fans already come to games dressed as empty seats.
Yes.
I'm looking forward to catching up with
Heath. He'll be good value tonight, Heath. That's one to bloody stick around for sure.
It's time to head back to the desk. James Vandermark, brilliant calling, and Sarah Allardyce, because I think it's been a positive start, hopefully anyway, for the Punters Club.
Thank you, Gareth. So the Punters Club is alive in all three quarters, so good job to everyone out there. Race five was a good one. So here's Tears, number 8. So that was Marty's tip. So well done, Marty. Good job. All over it.
Yes.
Well done, Marty.
So yes. I like to, when I'm calling a race, I have the window open. The last thing I need is to get a bit of wind chill coming in on me when trying to call the big group one. So I put the North Face on and I forgot I had to come down here. So that's why I'm still wearing the North Face. But next race number 6 is the feature. It's what we're all here for, the RSN 927 Sandown Cup. And I mean, the field is just full of intrigue because there are so many good greyhounds in the race, but they all are a little bit different in the way they go about their business. I settled on number 1 as the runner to beat Rockstar Beeve. I went 1, 2, 4, and 7. Second, I went with 2 Blazing Cartier, but I've got no doubt she wants to use a little bit of the track, so she's going to have to play for luck. He Shall Power is the greyhound that I just think could be absolutely anything. First go 700 last week for a young dog was just an enormous run, and I think I said in the call he's the young kid on the block, and that's exactly what he is in this final. Number 7, True Detective, just have to add him in. He's a genuine star, but I feel so bad because I'm leaving out greyhounds like Ella Enchanted, who ran second in the race last year, and she's only had 13 race starts since the Sandown Cup last year, and I think in the last 12 months this is probably the most racing she's had together at once, so she could be the improver. Great, well it looks like it's going to be a really close RSN Sandown Cup, so we'll throw back to you, Gareth.
Terrific feedback from some of the names from our viewers there, and there's some very funny names, Marty, it's coming through.
Well, some wonderful names coming in. I mean, it's interesting, isn't it, because I mean, how many dogs have there been over the years? It's been thousands and thousands. So, and you can't name a dog that's already been named. So you're going to be really sort of scratching your head. But one of my favourites was Fred Bassett. Yeah. Not a wonderful dog, but owned by Hamish and Andy and really brought people through the gates. We got any footage of Fred Bassett? Having a look? Let's have a look at Fred Bassett. People's Chance, what he was.
Living with a minor celebrity, it has its moments. He's occasionally called up on for a photo shoot or a video shoot, and back in the day he used to get invited to all sorts of things like Fox FM rooftop parties, and was once in a limousine with Megan Gale, so he sort of lived the high life, and you sort of reflect on that and you think, wow, here he is, an everyday pet.
Sometimes I Google him at school and my friends are like, oh wow, and stuff, yeah.
Fred sleeps for about 20 hours a day, so as long as he gets his walk in the morning, he's pretty happy just to come home and hop into his nice comfortable bed. He loves to eat his pasta with meat and vegetables every night, and he does have some chicken drumsticks for breakfast.
Yeah, look, I guess I spoil him a bit and usually walk him twice a day. Gets me out of the house, gets me fit. So really, he's been good for our lifestyle.
It gives my dad a reason to take us down to the park and have a kick, because generally he probably wouldn't. And
back when Fred was raced by Hamish and Andy, they'd often get him to eat chicken nuggets to try and predict sporting events. They were calling him Nostradamus back then. He just loved the chicken nuggets, and they were playing on it and got some really good airtime on Fox FM with him. It's a big step for greyhounds to come off the racetrack and into a domestic household, but they go through a foster care process through the adoption program. And once they settle in, they just love it. They just want the couch. They love to race. Greyhounds love to race, but they love the couch just as much.
It's the backstories,
yes,
that bring greyhound racing alive, I think. But there are some funny names out there. Trev, have you got any?
We had the Footy Show dog years ago called You Idiot.
Was it any good?
That's unfortunate.
He was good. He won quite a few cups. Yeah. He won another races. He was a pretty good dog. And the great thing was they used to bring him into the studio and he would just sleep. Yeah, he's the fastest dog in the world. Just cut to him.
Anyway. Hey, they are wonderful pets, greyhounds.
Maybe it's my jokes, but yeah. Sent in from Rob Barry from South Yarra. His famous one was Norma Stitz. I think you're supposed to say it quicker. Hey, I'm doing Dr. Terse material here.
Some of your best work, Trev.
But apparently Ron Hawkshaw used to begin a race call by saying Norma Stitz has been well supported. Right. Thanks, Rob.
Brilliant. I've got one.
Yep.
This is from Bullfhead from Springvale, who just lives around the corner here.
That'd be a good name for a dog.
Yeah.
Bullfhead from Springvale.
Hey, we should get that one. Yeah. We'll get that one through. Bullfhead from Springvale down the outside. He's nominated Puma Pants.
Oh.
It's a bit of 12th Man material, old Puma Pants.
Yeah, there we go.
Good old Puma Pants.
I've had Russell from Noosa's shot me an email.
Yep.
Hi to Russell. Lovely spot up there. If you want someone to come visit Russell, let me know. I'm not up to much. One that resonates with me through this crazy time, Pistol Knight. Yeah.
There was a dog I remember from years ago. The people lived down in Elwood near the canal there.
Yeah.
And because they were near the canal, they named the dog to be further away from the canal. I won't go any further than that. But
it wasn't the near canal.
No, it wasn't the near canal. No.
Just to
it
be
was
sure.
The other one. Look, if we've got to pick a winner, I think we look. Norma's tits is fantastic.
Yeah.
Really?
Don't you think?
Yeah, yeah.
I thought it was.
Well,
great.
You're not a fan, Trev.
No, that's fine. Okay. Yeah, Rob. Well done.
Yeah.
All right.
Beautiful work.
Thing.
Does he get a prize?
Does he get a prize? What does he get?
He's won a picture of
Sandown Park merchandise pack.
Sandown Park merchandise pack. Hey,
he can come and pick it up. He's from down there.
And the Ferrari. Well done. See.
Or he can take the cash.
We'll send the greyhound boy broke in.
The feature race isn't far away, the RSC 927 Sandown Cup. Some of the best stays in the country doing battle. And it's your turn to tip here, Trev.
My turn to tip? Well, look, I have to, obviously, claiming, I've done a little bit of form today.
Yeah.
But even so, I mean, it's an even race by the looks. And the old saying, when in doubt, go for the top weight. So,
Rockstar B.
One for me, Rockstar B.
We're on fire at the moment. We're one from one.
That can be a nomination for this.
Rockstar Beef. Have you ever had a greyhound named after you, Trev? There would have been, surely.
Off the top of my head, I don't know. There's been various marmalade horses.
Yeah. What about you, Daisy?
I got sent through a screenshot of a greyhound that ran some track during the week. Tilly Thomas, which of course my daughter's name. So I'm not sure we ever named it after her, but it won and I wasn't on it. So next time, give me the tip if you're going to use their name.
Well, I was at the races one day and a lady came up to me and she said, we've got a horse called Marmalade, which had one start for one win at the time. I said, oh, really? She said, it wasn't named after you, though.
Well,
okay.
Thanks for letting me know.
So Trev's bet is the $50.
So $50 for the, I'm going to go for the Mountain District Darts League.
There you go.
That sounds like a lot of fun.
Absolutely. $50 there. And the gift packs go to Springvale South Cricket Club, Roeville Cricket Club, and St. Bridget's St. Louis Cricket Club.
Yeah.
The Darts League.
Have you ever played darts?
The darts is unbelievable.
Darts would be better if they introduced a goalie.
Good luck getting that one past that way.
But it's all changed. Back in the days, when you see that, they all have a pint
and a cigarette while they're playing the game.
180.
And the athlete steps up to the hockey.
Yeah.
We they had the darts at the Etihad Stadium here in town a few years back when everyone went feral and threw the chairs and had a big riot.
That's right.
I was there on a Thursday night before a Saturday game. It was great. Running out like this.
I remember when I was in WA, they had the darts and the jockeys were there, and there was straight after a meeting at Ascot. And obviously they've been wasting and all that, and they had a few beers, and one of the jockeys got a little fired up, and they got all kicked out, all marched out of the stadium. It was quite funny that he had to be there. I reckon the darts would be good with the greyhounds. Yeah, the darts up here while the dogs.
Actually, I think we used to do nights here when you were allowed to do anything, where you could come and do like Olympic competitions, and one of them was a darts competition.
Yep.
Very good. It works.
We've got a punters club update as well.
Oh, what's going on?
You wonder how that stopped.
Blazy Cartier, we've got $200 to win at $4.20.
Wow.
And Just Terms, 100 each way at $7.50. She's been well supported.
Okay, so you're dissing my tip.
Yeah. We'll just put a line straight through it. So on Blazy Cartier, that's our best result. So at the moment, the pool's around, we've got about 1,000 in the kitty. We started off with 2,500. I think I'm reading that right. So there you go, $200
so
a win at 420.
All quaddies are still alive though.
It's we've got all like quaddies, really we're still alive.
You're at home watching and you're still behind at the minute, but that's all right, there's a long way.
No,
a lot of racing to go.
We've still got a few bets alive.
4 times 64.
Have you ever gone any good at a...
It has to be really hard to spend 600 on a dog's quaddie.
Nah, there's a $100,000 jackpot today.
Okay.
Yeah, so there's plenty of money in the pool. So if we get it, happy days. Have you ever won a punters club, Daisy?
Well, our greyhound was provided our punters club, but ours wasn't about punting. It was about getting away at the end of the footy season and having it all paid for. So I don't think I've ever ventured into a winning punters club, no.
Where'd you go for that footy trip?
Well, we only went to Sydney, hence never winning in the punters club. The $29 return flight on Virgin. Sorry to Virgin. Touchy subject.
I actually did it once at Mooney Valley. I ran the punters club there, and it was Mooney Valley Cup Day, and absolutely just slaughtered the punters club's dough from the start to beginning. Yeah. In the meanwhile, I've had a parlay 3-4 in Adelaide, which has got up.
And what did
I've
you?
Won an absolute poultice, and everyone in the room hates me.
Yeah.
And did you tell them?
Yep, they knew.
They're nearly set for the cup, not far away. We're on three greyhounds. Here's James Vandermark.
Runs in the 12 months between, but the favourite, the fastest qualifier from the inside, and that is Rockstar Beeve. What a great lineup it is, and they're nearly ready to go. So they're coming in, nearly set now for the Sandown Cup, the RSN Sandown Cup at Group 1 level, and the stayers are ready. Green light, set to go. Racing, jumping well from near the inside, Zipping Clifford out fast. Bronski Beat's going to cut and run tonight, straight over the lead by two lengths, Zipping Clifford, and True Detective a close third. Followed then by Rockstar Beeve, He Shall Power, well back to Ella Enchanted, Just Terms, and Blazing Cartier last of all. Under a lap to go to the railway side, and Bronski Beat, the tearaway leader in the Sandown Cup, out by four lengths, True Detective, Rockstar Beeve, then He Shall Power, Zipping Clifford, well back to Ella Enchanted, Just Terms, and last Blazing Cartier. Bronski Beat's a big leader, out by four lengths to True Detective, He Shall Power starting to wind up, but it's Bronski Beat clear, all out, but wins the Sandown Cup. Bronski Beat, a rough result, won at three quarters over True Detective, third He Shall Power, and then Ella Enchanted, followed by Rockstar Beeve, Blazing Cartier, and back at the tail, Just Terms, Zipping Clifford a fair way back. May well have faltered near the line, Bronski Beat, but lands the Group 1 Sandown Cup. I'll put in a very awkward stride right at the line, did Bronski Beat, but the job was well and truly over. Number 8 has won the Sandown Cup, Bronski Beat. And it is a blowout result in the Sandown Cup of 2020 once again. Rajasthan last year at a big price. And tonight for Brendan Purcell, who was placed in the race with Pippertide in a recent edition, has gone a couple better tonight, winning the Group 1 Sandown Cup from the outside with Bronski Beat. Second has gone to 7, True Detective. He ran on well. And third went to 4, He Shall Power. Well, he could be the boom stayer coming out.
Soon it's gonna be a little darling. We'll go riding on the horses, yeah, yeah. And way up in the sky, a little darling.
Beautifully done, boys. Hopefully we don't get to need to be picked up with the punters club, because did we have the eights in the quaddy? Bronski Beat, who, no, we didn't. Anyway, we've still got a little bit of money in the kitty. Hey, this is a great story.
The punters are saying, tell me why.
This is a good story because even though we didn't have in the punters club, there's been no racing over in Tassie. So Bronski Beat was a greyhound trained over there and they sent it over to Brendan Purcell, and they've just won the RSN 927 Sandown Cup, Trev.
There we go. Well, luck's a fortune.
It is.
You'd have to say.
Yeah, they'll be cheering in Tassie. They haven't had much to cheer about, but they get the chocolates there. One of my favourites is Johnny Sadler. He's one of the great horse trainers. Very funny man. And he's been in the news of late. Starring there at Flemington by playing a couple of practical jokes. Johnny Sadler, welcome.
Thanks, Gareth.
Well done, Johnny.
Thank you.
I heard you'd gone viral. I thought, oh no, is he okay? And no, he's gone the other viral. Johnny Sadler gone viral. Did you ever think?
I'd much prefer to be here and having me snapping goals from the middle of the MCG like our man Daisy here, instead of being famous for giving Damien Oliver a decent spray. But
we might show that spray, Johnny, and I'll paint the picture here. Ollie was riding a horse for you called Bee Hunter. He didn't have the best of luck, and this is the scene straight after the race when Ollie headed back to report back to John.
And it's the spray that's got the racing world talking. A video showing trainer John Sadler giving Damien Oliver some colourful advice went viral after he rode Bee Hunter to an unlucky second at Flemington yesterday.
I mean, how the f*** can a horse win when you ride it like that? You just let the other f***ing thing go. You can get f***ed, Ollie. I don't want you riding for
me.
But it turns out the video was a setup and just a bit of fun for Sadler's Caulfield stable. I think Ollie could get a job on Home and Away after.
John did pretty well too. They had me full.
And it was interesting to hear the comments or read the comments below, because there's some that actually believed it was real. And I might have to put my hand up. I thought you were serious there, because it was a terrible ride by Ollie, wasn't it? Really?
I wasn't as upset, actually, as I've been other times with these rides, Gareth. But, yeah, there was plenty wanted to look at it from both sides. I was getting... I couldn't believe, like, it was meant for actually.
So who put you up to it, John?
Well, what happened was Clinton McDonald thought that I would be giving Ollie a decent spray after the race, because he thought it was a bad ride. So he rang Mick Price and asked him, would he video me and Ollie together after the race? And Mick passed this on to me. And so I said, I'll give him a proper show here. So I said to Ollie as he's coming towards me, I said, mate, this is just a G-up, but just go along with it. So away we went, and I couldn't believe to think that it was on the Channel 7 news the next night. Was just unbelievable.
That's obviously the G-up. Who's the jockey you've given the best spray to, and what did it contain?
I reckon Craig Williams on a couple of occasions. Yeah, I've given him a couple of decent sprays. Mm. And
do you remember the horse or the ride?
One of them was in Dubai. Yeah, there you go. One of them was in Dubai. But I actually sprayed him before the race, because he actually told me how he was going to ride this horse in a big sprint over there, and it was contradictory to the way I was wanting him to have it. So I told him in no uncertain terms that we were going my way, not his way.
And what eventuated, John?
And it won, actually. Yeah, okay. Yes.
So, well, perhaps give him a spray beforehand.
Yeah.
But I suppose that would, is that gone out of the game a little bit?
I think it has a little bit.
Although Peter Moody's back in the ranks.
Yes, he is.
That'll bring it back, surely.
He's not bad at it. But I think since the punt probably not being as big as what it used to be, and I think I was given some advice a long time ago, and it was great advice, but I didn't always adhere to it, but was that if you were really disappointed in a jockey's ride, don't go back to the mounting yard, just walk away. So you save him the grill and you save yourself from making a spectacle.
Well, it's the old saying though, John, isn't it, that with riding instructions, the good ones don't listen, the bad ones can't carry them out?
Yes, that's very, very true.
Johnny, I've been to Caulfield Trackwork and in the gallops, the trainers at Caulfield, you've got a trainer's box and you have so much fun up there. Is it you only have the fun when the cameras are there?
Well, look, you know what, Gareth, it reminds me of the shearing sheds. I used to work in shearing sheds, and sometimes, shearers work extremely hard and it's monotonous work. I'm not saying training horses is monotonous work, but it's early hours in the morning and sometimes you can become a bit bored, and people just take the absolute mickey out of each other at Caulfield. There's no holds barred, and sometimes I even cringe when I hear some of the things that are said, but we've got this great camaraderie, such as was the case that was only supposed to go, what we saw before with Ollie, to the Caulfield trainers, and my beautiful partner Shannon was on her second bottle of red, and I actually sent it to her and she put it on my Instagram, which was terrific of her, and away it went.
Yeah, mate, so what are you going to do when Caulfield shouts for the trainers?
I'm going to a private training complex. It's really extremely disappointing that we're closing down.
Absolutely.
And it'll be a sad day when we all go, but anyway, everybody's going different ways. Some going to Pakenham, some to Cranbourne, others to Ballarat. I'm going to a private training complex owned by Eddie Hirsch up at Tielden.
Okay. Have you got a winner for us, Johnny, before we let you go?
In the coming, yeah, I've got a horse that's an emergency on Sunday, owned by some of the Port Melbourne guys. Horse, I'm just trying to think of his name. South Parade is his name.
Okay.
And he ran a nice fifth here across the road a couple of weeks ago, and I think he's ready to win. He's in Sunday at Ballarat.
Of course, Johnny, you've got a promising horse who's been out for a little while now, Big Night Out.
Yeah,
what are the plans for him? He looks like a spring horse.
Yeah, he is a spring horse, and he's spelling at the moment.
Where's he headed? What's the plan?
He'll be coming in. I think a race like maybe the Emirates, whenever it's going to be, I don't know if it's the last day of the carnival or what, but he was still going through his grade, so he was a very smart galloper.
Johnny, thanks for that, because we've got to let you go because we've got some breaking news. We're heading to the White House. Donald Trump's about to join us. Hello, Donald.
It's great to see you. Thank you so much, Gareth. It's huge. I'm very excited to be here. We love the Duds, and we're making racing great again. It's going to be huge. And we're building, by the way, when it's live and exclusive news, we're building a giant wall around Australia. We're getting New Zealand to pay for it. It's going to be really huge, big league. Thank you so much.
Oh, sorry, Donald. Do you like the dogs? Have you ever been to the Greyhounds?
I love the dogs. If it's cold enough, they're terrific. I have been to the Greyhounds. I really love a good race. For me, it's a great thing because I'm in the presidential race and I want to watch some of these guys. They're like rockets that are being launched. They're really good, and I love the dogs. They're red, white, and blue, like my colors here. So very much we love the dogs in the White House. So it's huge. I'm really excited for it.
Mr. Trump, Dale Thomas here. You've probably heard of me. You're talking of rockets being launched. The dogs launched like rockets. You've just developed a rocket that can be launched 17 times faster than any other rocket. Why?
That's right. 17 times faster than China and Russia. They got some big rockets, but ours is 70, and we're calling it the super duper rocket, the super duper missile. And we're launching this. We're going to be telling this at the next World Leaders Summit and telling everybody about it, or as I like to call it, show and tell, telling everyone about my huge super duper racket. It's amazing. It's tremendous. It really is.
Donald, I thought you'd be odds on to catch coronavirus, but you've been able to escape it so far. How are you going?
Great news. Well, you know, during this, I don't call it the COVID-19, it's the China virus. The China virus, we're doing very well. We're social distancing from a lot of people like the Democrats, CNN reporters, Sleepy Joe. It's very easy to stay away from a lot of these people, really is, believe me. But Melania's doing very, very well during quarantine. She finished three books, which is a lot of coloring in, believe me. She's doing very well.
Well, Mr. President, obviously you've got a lot of fans down here. I mean, there's a lot of people building their own walls here and injecting a bit of disinfectant. Do you plan to come down here and visit them soon?
Well, I would love to. I miss Australia. I was saying to Melania, I really miss Australia. I miss New Zealand, miss Mexico, miss Brazil, miss Argentina. She is fantastic, really tremendous, tremendous lady.
Australia to the US to be lifted soon. I've got a mate, Dane Swan, who'd love to get to Vegas very quickly.
Well, I've heard of Swanning, and he's welcome to come back when we lift those travel bans. But at the moment, you know, you see why we want walls around our borders, because we want to protect. A lot of bad people have come into our country. And I was telling Melania, I was saying to my first lady, third wife, but first lady, I was saying we need to stop illegals coming in and stealing our jobs. That's what we've got to do.
Did she say, Donald?
Well, she didn't really understand. She's from Slovenia, so I just gave her my credit card. I sent her shopping, so what can you do? So, yeah.
And finally, Mr. President, you received a lot of backlash about not wearing a mask. How are you dealing with this?
Well, I'm really fine, because I've been pumping myself, as you said, with all the disinfectant, all of those things. But we're doing fine. I was encouraging the Democrats to wear the masks, not so much because of the health reasons. Have you seen these people? I mean, seriously, they need to be wearing masks a lot. There's a lot of bad people out there. And believe me, we love dogs, but we don't want to say anything about these people being like that at all. But thank you so much. It really has been a huge, huge honor for you to hear me speak here tonight. And I thank you so much.
Good on you, Donald. Stay healthy, and hopefully we'll see you in Australia soon. Good on you. Donald Trump joining us from the
Trumpy.
White House.
You've opened with Trumpy. G'day, Trumpy. Keep it professional.
Fake news. James Vandermark, yes. Brilliant. Welcome back to the show. Terrific call of the RSZ 927 Cup.
Yeah, mate, it was a bit of a surprise, though. Yeah. I must say, I was sitting up there in the broadcast, and when they swung for home, I thought, well, Bronski beat races home to win the Sandown Cup. And right near the line, I think the end of the 7:15, really, he was starting to call out for help, really, but was just able to get home. I thought the runners-up went really well, but how about Hishel Powell? I mean, in football terms, Daisy, this is a greyhound who's effectively an 18-year-old coming playing the AFL and you know, playing a best-on-ground performance. I thought it was an enormous run.
Yep, liked it. Been there, done it also, so it's great news.
Is your rising star, James?
Yeah, mate, I think so. The rising star would go to Hishel Powell, why not? But no, mate, it was a terrific race. And look, it was a race that I must say, I spoke to Neil Brown just off air a moment ago, and I said to Neil, the only greyhound that can't win the race is Bronski Beat. And that's what I said to him, I reckon, 15 minutes ago. And Neil said, well, I've put it in the quaddie as a bit of a roughie. And look, I thought it would struggle to get across from box number 8. But once it sped over, took the lead, it was just too good. But Punters Club, I've got some bad news for those playing the Punters Club. Okay. All of the quaddies have lost, but the ship has not sunk just yet. We've got $200 a win on Captain Jake in the next, and $100 each way on Weblex Smoke. So we're hoping to save it in the next, Gareth.
All right, then. And we should have got Mr. Brown.
Well, that does seem a bit hasty, if you don't mind me saying. I mean, if you had the 200 and the thing that wins, it's up to 100 each way, right?
Yeah. No, look, I'm not too sure, to be honest. As I said, it was myself, Georgie Ferrugia as well. So I'm not sure. And Joey Jackson, I think, has been putting these together.
He's throwing everyone under the bus.
I've had nothing to do with it now.
James, you call the action superbly. I think you train a few greyhounds, but you also help out Sandown with the syndications. And it's a great initiative from the club. RSN have got a couple of greyhounds, and we've been going okay of late.
Yeah, look, I think the racewith.com.au National Greyhound Syndications has been a massive, massive success. I mean, it's just a fantastic way to get involved in greyhound ownership. If you're sitting at home and you've got absolutely no idea how to get involved with greyhound ownership, but you want the thrill and the enjoyment of being a part of it, well, racewith.com.au is the perfect way to go. Not only, Gareth, do you get a share of one dog, but you get a share of a couple of young pups. You get to see them grow up. You get all of the information as they're going through their break-in stage, learning to race, when they start trialing. And the number one draft pick of the first year has been a huge success. A greyhound by the name of Wallbanger. I'm sure if you've watched the races, you would have seen him go around. And he's been a terrific greyhound. So if you want to get involved, racewith.com.au, it's the best way to go. And so what, mate, I must say...
sorry, James, what sort of investment are we talking about?
Oh, look, it's
if
about...
If you want to play small.
It's about, I think, about 2,000. 1,200, there you go, even cheaper than 2,000. So $1,200, I mean, and a group of guys or girls can get together and put in $300 each and buy one share. So I think it's a great way to go. My phone's going, so someone's obviously already wanting to get into racewith.com.au.
Roll the video. Roll the video, let's play it.
Get into greyhound racing for just $1,200 a share. After your initial investment, there's no more to pay. Experience the excitement. Experience winning. Select your team and join industry leaders. For more information and to read Primary Securities, the PDS which you should consider before applying, head to racewith.com.au.
Yep, so way to go. The National Greyhound Syndications and hopefully the RSN Syndication Dogs can be absolute champions. Hey, Jimmy, what about your tips for the next race?
Yeah, next race, a good race, 5.95 the distance. I went 5, 7, 3, and 8. And as I said, there's a few of us in the punters club, so they've gone against my selections. And you know what happens when you go against your selections, they come out and win and vice versa. But I think if the 5 gets half a run, she's a daughter of Xylia Allen, who won a Sapphire Crown here a few years ago. This greyhound finished off 4th in that race 2 starts ago, and I thought it was a terrific run.
All and right, in mate. The spirit of Bronski, but give us one, another one dog that can't win.
Claire, very good, Trevor, very good. Who can't win? Let's say the red and watch it win.
Okay, all right, then.
The red.
We'll get on.
Number one.
Good calling, James.
Right. Thanks, G Hall.
Time to head over to Marty and Sarah because they're about to play a game, Pick a Dog Box. What's that all about, Sarah?
We sure are. Welcome back, guys. So I've got Marty next to me now. So I've got a different co-host with me.
Prettier.
Prettier. Obviously.
Gareth, the way this works, it's remember that old game Concentration where you had to you had the cards all laid out and you turn them over and try and match a jack and oh you turn them back because it got it wrong and then oh I remember where the jack is when you got another jack, that sort of thing. This is what we're doing over here on Pick a Dog Box, but we've actually got a home player. We've got Ron Partington joining us. Are you there, Ron? Hello, Ron. Ron.
Live TV, we love.
No, that's okay.
We love live TV.
We're caught. Ron called us in from the coma ward at the Monash Hospital, and Ron's lost interest. Could have won it. Actually, they are playing for a lot of money. I just wanted to point out there are prizes up there like $1,500, $2,000. Even if they don't get a match, they win $500. So the way it's going to work is that why don't we bring Johnny over? We'll get Johnny. Johnny, come over here, mate. So, Johnny, what you see before you there is our... They're not real races. They're fictional races. We need you to pick a dog in the first race, a dog in the second race, a dog in the third, and a dog in the fourth. Now, Sarah, correct me if I'm wrong, because I usually am. If any of those two matches...
Yes, so
he's in the money.
If you get two that match, that is what you get. So we've got a tab voucher there. The major prize is $5,000. So the most that you can win is $5,000. So if you get two of $5,000, then you're a winner. $500. So either way, you're a winner.
So John, in these tough financial times, if you do win the $5,000, mate, who are you donating that to?
To Ron.
Yeah, to Ron.
Yeah, beautiful.
So Ron still gets the charity prize. We're playing on behalf of Ron, just to clarify.
Yes. Yeah, yes. That's true. Yes. That's true. All right.
We'll go the red in the first one.
All right, let's turn that around,
one,
Sarah, see what we've got.
Turn around number one and the Sandown Classic. That's a
250. Got to do a bit better than that.
That's a 250 tab voucher.
The 8.
Whoa, gone to pink. Okay.
Don't have to walk far for that
one. No, you don't.
Thank you.
Whoa, 2,000. All right. Next one down.
The 2.
Okay.
Oh, he's gone the check. Look out. Whoa. Now, you've got a match. 250, 750 or 2,000. Is that correct?
Yes.
Yes, but if you don't match, you still win 500. So you're actually Well, you're gonna be all right.
The six.
We've gone the six. Called the green. Used to be the brown.
All right. Getting my prices right on.
$3,000
cash. Right. So none of them match, but you still win $500 for Ron on behalf of Ron.
Yeah, good old Ron. He's going to need that to get the shock therapy to get him out of his coma. So that's wonderful to have Ron playing a vital role in this tonight.
Thanks for joining us, Ron.
Beautiful, Johnny, and thanks for joining us tonight.
Pleasure. Sorry to Ron.
Thank you for standing in.
Gareth, back to you, my mate.
Hey, that's one of my favourite games, Pick a Dog Box.
Oh, I tell you what, I wish I'd been at that meeting when they came up with it. That would have been so much fun.
Hey, we've still got the Sandown wheel, and it's a chance for a sporting club.
Okay, so this one I get.
Yeah, we just spin the wheel.
Yeah, no, good concept.
You made it, didn't you? It was Billy's wheel, wasn't it?
Billy's wheel.
Billy's wheel.
Pluck a duck.
Yeah,
pluck a duck. That was another one, famously, yeah. The wheel thing.
Yeah.
Yeah, no, it's
got legs. He's running back for the
little
wheel.
Little duck leg.
Yeah.
Leg.
Daisy, it's up to you. It's your turn to punt.
Okay. Well, I will be punting on behalf of the Hallam Cobras Softball Club.
Yeah.
I used to play a bit of softball as a junior.
Did you?
Not very good.
Really?
Really large ball. It's kind of...
Wow.
Anyhow.
Okay.
It's not the point.
My whole opinion of you.
I'm not going to go with our...
softball.
Ron's back. Ron's back. Sorry,
that seemed
I've got
to go
distracted.
Pretty well, Marty.
Marty, Captain Jake the Seven.
So okay.
Captain Jake the Seven to the Hallam Cobras, Langwarrin Soccer Club, Montrose Footy Club, and Bayswater Striker Soccer Club all get the hamper.
Okay.
So good luck to you all.
So currently at $3.40 with tab.com.au, and the greyhound that James said it couldn't win was Silver Smarty.
Okay.
$6.50.
Mm. Only $6.50.
Yeah.
Well, I'm back.
It's been hammered.
Yeah. It's been the best back greyhound after he declared that. James Vandermaert's not far away. He does a really good job, doesn't he, James? He talks to us for about 10 or 15 minutes. Obviously, he doesn't have to learn his colours. He's pretty good.
Well, they're kind of the same.
Yeah, they are. Hey, Marty, you need to make sure you think of a word for him in the next race.
I don't have a microphone at the moment, so I just thought I'd point that out. I was trying to slide around it, but no, we've gone straight through it.
I got one. Toupee.
Toupee
into the... Yeah, all right, see if we can get that
can
into
we pick
there.
A word each?
Oh, that'll be difficult in 30 seconds.
That's 30 whole seconds. Come on. For some people, then. That's a long time.
You can ask him.
We'll speak to him after
Toupee. You can think of one, right. Daisy. They're nearly so. I think they're being boxed here for race number 7 here at Sandown. Let's head up to the man, James Vandermaert, for the call.
Here, Captain Jake, they're at the start now, Sandown.
He looks so disoriented.
Race 7 on Cup Night, and they're at the start now and about to move in. So they're starting to get ready here. How about that for an outsider winning the Sandown Cup in back-to-back years? It was coast to coast, barrier to box, and it was a smart win, Bronski B. Was just able to steal the Sandown Cup with great sections going all of the way from the Extreme Alley box number 8. Race 7 loading up, 5.95. The middle distance now, Racing Pulse, 8.30am weekdays, mix 4 and 5. And the last of them are getting ready over there at the 5.95. Favourites drawn in a pretty open race, box number 7, Captain Jake. A few of these, if they could lob close, they'll be very strong at the end. Tallulah Bale, potentially as well, Waging War, who got ran down last time, and they are nearly set to go. Race 7, green light turned on, ready at Sandown Park. The favourite in 7, Captain Jake, set. Racing, Captain Jake out fast from the outside. He's going to cross and lead by 3 lengths, Silver Smarty early. Running up to third, the outside, Waging War, followed by Tallulah Bale, who's starting to slice through. They're followed by Weblek Smoke, Road to Success, Blinkin' Billy. And last of all, Fairy Tale Wish down the back, and Captain Jake's out and running. Led by 3 lengths over Silver Smarty, Waging War, and then Road to Success, and the rest headed by Blinkin' Billy. But Captain Jake going well. Turn for the judge by 5 to Waging War, Road to Success. It is all Captain Jake. He's bolting away. Captain Jake won it by 4, beating Waging War. Third to Blinkin' Billy, a photo for Silver Smarty or Road to Success, and then Weblek Smoke, Fairy Tale Wish, and last to Tallulah Bale. It's a smart run, 34-14 for Captain Jake. The
was just too quick for the man. 909 early.
Now love me when you go crazy. Take all my inhibition. Baby, there's nothing holding me back. You take my places to tear up my reputation. Manipulate my decision. Baby, there's nothing holding me back. Oh, no, no, no. Oh, no, no. Baby, there's nothing holding me back.
Good are our band?
The Downward Dogs.
Yeah. Aren't they magnificent?
Brandon and Al.
Never had a lesson.
Brilliant.
The Howling Cobras Softball Club.
We're up and about. You're
bloody welcome.
You're the pin-up boys.
$50.
Yeah, get me down there.
Are you gonna be? You won't have to pay for a drink down there.
Perfect.
I was a little nervous about the one there when it loomed up out of the home straight for the first time.
The only dog that couldn't win when that loomed up.
I wonder what James was thinking down the back. time to welcome in our next guest. He is one of the superstars of the AFL, premiership player at the Magpies, and now he is doing great stuff at the Giants over there in Sydney. I speak of Heath Shaw. G'day, Heath. Thanks for joining us, mate.
I think he's in a... He joined my bloke in the Monash Hospital.
Yeah.
He's gone. But it's interesting what's happened here, because clearly he's dropped his webcam down the plug hole and can't get it out.
I never knew he didn't like it that much.
Do you want
style?
Me just to FaceTime him off my phone or get him up that
well,
way?
Is he to someone that you sort of stayed in touch with since your time?
Yeah, most definitely. I called him on the way in here tonight. He's one of my good mates, Heath. Yeah. Him and I are very like-minded, approached our football very much the same. Very, very competitive on the field, but pretty relaxed off it. So if he does answer the phone again, it'll be good fun to talk to. But if not, I could tell you what he was going to say. It'll be the same old cliches about everyone's going well. I've tried not to get fat.
When was the first time you spoke to him after the grand final?
Recently. I think he rang
after
me.
After the grand final debacle.
Hit show, you could call. He rang me about 5:45 in the morning, I think.
I thought you were going to say 3/4
nah.
time.
He could have.
We're buggered. We're gone.
I think he was too busy looking for a chiropractor watching the ball go over his head so much. He rang me a few times that morning. I obviously wasn't out to that hour, but he was somewhere. Here he is, the great man.
There he is.
He's back. Can you hear us, Heath?
I got you, boys. How are we?
Yeah.
We're going well, mate. More importantly, how are you?
Yeah, no, I was just watching that last race while you guys called. You interrupted me, so I quickly hung up. But yeah, back on now, all good.
Now, if you speak a bit softer, mate. Unfortunately, we can still hear a couple of words. Mate, Marty Fields here. We had a few laughs last year. I think it was actually here at Sandown Greyhound Track, as a matter of fact. As a Richmond supporter, I just wanted to congratulate you on the 5 goals your team kicked in the grand final. A beautiful game. Now, how's it all going up there in Sydney? At GWS, of course, you know, you guys are obviously behind closed doors there, training away in secret, similar to your games. And like my daughter said, how many GWS supporters does it take to change a light bulb? I said both of them. Going all right? He's frozen.
Oh, he's frozen.
G'day, G'day Marty. I don't remember you from last year, but that's all right.
Now, seriously, is the grand final last year, is that something you've done the review of, or is the coach just gone, you know what, we're forgetting all about that, or have you had to suffer through the pain?
No, we didn't do a review. I think we just sort of had a chat about it when we first got back to pre-season and discussed sort of what happened and how we all felt about it. But then after that, we were all good to go. It was a long year. We had a good final series, but we just that last day in September, we weren't so great.
Anyway, that's enough of GWS. Let's talk North Melbourne. When did you first look at your brother, Reece, and go, now there is an AFL coach in waiting for sure?
I can't believe he's still a coach. He's an AFL coach. I've seen him at race days and at Mad Mondays and all of the above, and now he's an actual AFL coach. So it's a pretty amazing effort for him.
How surprised were you that came about?
I think the last sort of 3 years, I thought, like when he was assistant coach at Swans and moved to the Kangaroos, I thought that might be the way he wanted to go about things. But yeah, from going to where he was as an assistant to actually getting one of 18 jobs is a pretty good effort.
Well, mate, you play the Roos first up, or second up as it is now, but you still got plenty of time to sledge each other leading up to the resumption.
Yeah, we do. We got a bit of time. The fixtures come out last week, and Reese was first to text me about the fact that we're playing them up here. So looking forward to that. Obviously, the family can't come and watch, so there's no real point in talking about them or getting tickets for them. But, yeah, we're looking forward to kicking off the second part of the season.
It was a miracle that you got another year, mate, and I didn't. Are you concerned now that they're going to cut lists and you're going to be all for nothing and you've done two pre-seasons in one? Because I know how much you strongly dislike a pre-season. Have you done it all for nothing?
Nah, I'm in pretty good shape. I saw you in the jungle, mate, and you're lucky you went in the jungle because you lost about 12 kilos that you needed to. But no, the I suppose the season that it is now is going to be a bit more unique, but they still need the old timers in there telling what to do. So I think my spot's secure for now.
You were smart enough at the start of lockdown to call up a favour from your friends at Rochford Basket Press to get a dozen delivered. Is there any left?
That will go on the first couple of hours, mate. Don't you worry about that. But no, I've definitely been. It's tough. The AFL are actually encouraging you staying home and drinking by yourself. So I live by myself. So it's not ideal. But one good thing is I got that delivery of Rockford and the races and the greyhounds are still on. So that's positive.
And obviously, having no girls over isn't an issue for you, so you're walking around that one perfectly. Now, our 2010 Premiership reunion was this year. We're all planning on lining the pockets and going from event to event. What do we do? Have you got any ideas? You're the smart man amongst the group, which you don't look it, but you actually are pretty intelligent sometimes.
That's more a reflection on his 14,
yeah.
Mate.
Yeah, correct.
It's the 10-year anniversary. Like what most Premiership teams have, just a 10-year anniversary. We decided to have one every year. So this was the big banger, the 10-year one. I think there was a whole weekend planned, and I was going to have the week off that week because I still played, I'm not you. But yeah, we sort of missed out on that. So we're just going to have to make the 11th year bigger and better than ever.
Now, Heath, did you have an end of year trip after the game last year? Did you guys go away at all?
Yeah, we went back to Sydney from Melbourne.
Oh, I love it. Yeah, good. That's a long way these days.
That's a luxury.
Yes.
Hey, Heath, I know you love your racing, and I think you did some work experience with Anthony Cummings recently. Is there a chance that after your football days that you might go down that path and train thoroughbreds?
Ed Cummings is stables. He's just gone out on his own. So met him through a mate and went and spent a couple of days with him. And yeah, 5 a.m. starts, not ideal. I'm usually getting home at 5 and not starting at 5. So that was a little bit unique for me. But yeah, I do love the horses. Love going to the races. And I've actually got a horse that's running, having its first start tomorrow at Geelong in the first race called Angel Walker.
Yeah.
I think it's 20-1. It should be 250-1. But yeah, it'd be good to see it go around. It's got some very nice colours, so make sure you check it out.
Well, tell us a bit about the horse then, Heda. Who trains it? What's its breeding?
It's out of Hinchinbrook, and the trainer is Maddie Raymond, who used to work for Darren Weir, and she's gone out on her own as well. So we've given her a chance to train our horse. She's very, very conservative, not giving it any chance in the world. I said to her, you got to learn the game. Even if it's no chance, just tell us for a little bit of a sniff so we can waste our money on it.
Have you got a good punting story for us?
I've got a few. My favourite one and my best one was a horse called Hootson. It won the Magic Millions. I backed it at... I actually wanted to back it at 100-1 before it even had a start. Couldn't find it in the markets. It had a trial, won the trial by 5. It went into 11-1 to win the Magic Millions. I rang up a mate who works for a betting agency and said, what odds can you give me on this horse? And he said, I'll give you 50-1. I said, I'll have 10,000 on it. He said, are you serious? I said, no. I'll have 500 on it and, yeah, won 25 grand. It jumped as a $4 favourite, so...
Just before we let you go, mate, I'm curious about the artwork behind you, because at the moment it looks like you've got a burrito sticking out of your ear. Your house, your choice?
Yeah. Yeah, that's it's a burnout. It's an old HQ Holden doing a burnout, and on the number plate is light them up. So
that was my second guess.
Yeah, it's a nice we'll get up.
Similar to the you and Alan Dardak driving through Q that night. Yeah. We'll leave it at that. Thank you.
I think that's cut. Hey, good on you, Heath. Hopefully you can get the premiership this year, mate, and stick it up, Marty, there with the GWS Giants. Thanks for your time, mate, and good luck with your horse tomorrow.
No worries. Thanks for having me on, guys.
There good we go. Heath Shaw, sure. Great to catch up with Heath. He's a terrific. And he loves his horse racing, so hopefully that horse can win tomorrow.
Ironically, got a picture of a burnout behind him.
Hey, we've got to get to James because you've got to go and call the next. And Sarah, hey, we're still alive in the punters club. Trev wants you to let it all ride.
At least up the ante, James. Yeah. Come on. You're back the winner.
Well, that's not my decision, but I'll ask the people up the top. No, the Punters Club is still alive, so we won 680 with Captain Jake in that one, which is awesome. So that was race 7. Now I'm back with the man of many outfits, yes. And I was expecting you to come down in a high-vis vest. You disappointed me.
The funny thing was I went searching for a high-vis vest. I went to Jason Adams' office, and we couldn't find one anywhere. We've got one now.
Bring
come on,
it over.
Bring it over. I'll just hold it because I am the man of many different outfits tonight. I won't put it on, but this just shows you I did go to the effort of getting a high-vis.
It's all
vest.
About the effort.
Okay. Punters Club is still alive, which is the good thing. We're only hanging, I guess, just in contact with the Punters Club. 300 to win Hardstyle Rico in the next race. $100 each way on Leon Bale. And I think the Punters Club, Trev, have just completely ignored me here because I tip number one on top and they clearly know that my tips aren't going well, so they've said anything but, which seemed to work better in the last race as well. So next race isn't too far away. Let's look at my selections if they are worth looking at. 1, 3, 4, and 2 I've gone with. I just think Security Code's drawn really well. He's won 3 races from box number 1. That is a huge plus. Hardstyle Rico, though, number 3, is one of the fastest greyhounds in the country. If he gets any luck, he's going to be a huge player. 4 Aston Silk, who ran a belting race here in the Sapphire Crown 2 runs ago. Look, was she disappointing last start at Bendigo, or was she just a little bit flat from that run? We'll just have to wait and see. And number 2, Giggling Gertie, loves an inside draw, gets the nice run through behind Security Code. However, I am pretty keen on the chances of Security Code, but as I said, Joey Jackson, he looked at me before and he said, your tipping's been terrible. So he said, we're going Hardstyle Rico, Leon Bale, and we can get this Punters Club back up and going.
We've got this. I can feel it. Thank you, man of many outfits, yes. Also known as James.
Thank you.
Back to you, Gareth.
James, we've got a word for you.
Oh, is it a good one?
Trev, what was the word that you wanted to give James?
Toupee.
Toupee.
Pop it in there. Get it into the
Is that the hair?
Yeah.
It's nice. A funny story. Yeah. Isolation at the moment, as we all are in.
Haircut,
it's my lovely wife who does it. So as long as she's happy, I'm happy, Trev. And I think that's what's the saying?
Happy wife, happy life.
So I'm rolling with that one.
By the look of that haircut, I don't think she was too
happy. Yeah, and I'll tell you what, much disappointment for greyhound owners all around the country that the name Short Pork has already been taken.
Yes. It's a really good greyhound Short Pork.
Well, I tell you what, I was going to call my greyhound Short Pork. Damn.
I think we're heading back to Betty Price, who was the man who impersonated the great Donald Trump. You there, Ben?
I'm here, mate. It's good to see you. It's good to be not Donald Trump anymore. It's good to see you. Thank you so much, mate.
Now, you've got a few other individuals that you play. What about Bruce McAvaney? Can you give us a little bit of Bruce?
Yeah, well, it's pretty hard for him to call anything at the moment because there's nothing on. In case he called the greyhounds, but he's having to call, just the night at home with his wife. Gee, it's a delicious meal, isn't it? It's all there, the peas, the gravy, the potatoes. There's the tablecloth. Clever. Some peas are going to drop on the ground. It's going to leave a mark on the carpet. What a mark. That's special. It's exciting.
Done some beautiful work together, you and I, Ben. Marty Fields here, mate.
You have, mate. Thank you.
Lovely to see you again. Looking very, very well. You're a man of a thousand voices, mate. Your Schwarzenegger, of course, is absolutely unparalleled. In fact, he came second to you in an Arnold Schwarzenegger sound-alike competition.
Exactly. Yeah, but it's been really tough at the moment because, all the gyms, they're closed at the moment and everybody's homeschooling and it's hard. They're complaining like girly men. Come on, here's what you're going to do. Put those kids on your shoulders and do a squat. And pretty soon your forearms, they'll be like 8 arms and you'll be back. So thank you.
Mate, I'm a touch nervous about all this COVID stuff. Do you reckon Dr. Phil could give me some advice, please?
Well, I got to say, Daisy, I'm a little nervous too. It's crazier than a run-over dog. Well, I shouldn't say that about what's going on, but I got to say, I mean, have you seen some of the folks out there getting toilet rolls? Somewhere out there, a village is missing its idiot. I'm so confused. I don't know if I should scratch my watch or wind my butt. That's pretty crazy right there.
Well, and it's been a while since we heard from the Prime Minister. any word from him?
The Prime Minister, I love how he says everything in threes. Like, you know, we've got to flatten the curve. We've got to cushion the blow. We've got to download the app, do a jigsaw puzzle. And me and the girls did one the other day, and I was pretty excited. I finished in a week, said 3 to 4 years on the box. You know what I mean?
What about the UK Prime Minister, Boris Johnson?
Everyone's favourite, Boris Johnson. It's so good to see you here. We just had a baby, so I had to get checked because I had the coronavirus. And my doctor said, you look pasty. You're trying to think of words to say. Your hair's all messed up. I said, good, back to normal. Things in business again. Thank you.
I've got a couple more for you. Robert De Niro.
You got to get the whole Robert De Niro face, you know what I'm saying? It's been pretty tough, but the good news is we are doing a new movie with Quentin Quarantino, so there you go.
Bear Grylls?
Okay. Bear Grylls from Man vs. Wild. It's been really, really tough because they say during quarantine it can get really nasty. A man gets in hospital every 90 minutes. Just imagine how much pain that poor man must be in. Thank you so much.
And the last one before you let you go, Homer Simpson.
You got to have a bit of Homer Simpson. When I first heard about lockdown, I was like, no! But then I realized, Corona is sitting down on the couch, doing nothing but watching TV for 2 months. Woohoo! It's so much fun. Thank you so much.
Benny, guys, you're superb, mate. Great stuff.
Nothing like having a chat and having a couple of delays. It's awesome, and I really appreciated it. And I'll recommend you guys to other comedians. You know what? I don't know if you're on Cameo, mate, but you can get all these guys on Cameo. Come to your phone if you want to book them for your birthday, and check that out, cameo.com. Just a shameless little plug there.
Get on cameo.com. We will follow it up. Good on you, Benny. Thanks for that.
You do, mate. I appreciate it a lot. Thanks, guys.
Thank you, Benny Price. Back to Sarah and Marty.
Really happening over here, because you know we had the pick a dog box before. Well, now, Sarah, tell me about this wheel. Look at that thing. What a great prop.
We have the Sandown Super Wheel here. So we had a lot of people enter this competition, a lot of clubs. So this wheel is for the clubs. And we had a John Raphael from Seaford Football Club who was the winner drawn. My local, go Seaford. John, are you there?
That's extraordinary. John, thank you so much for joining us tonight. So, mate, by the way, this is going to work. We're going to spin this wheel, and you could win anything up to, I think, $2,500.
This one is $10,000 for your club.
Well, not for you. It's for your club. Yes. But $10,000, that's a lot. Jeez. Down in Seaford, $10,000, that buys a lot of souvlakis. Yeah, beautiful, mate. It's a great club. I've done a few shows there. Very, very good blokes. And are you looking forward to getting back on the pitch? All right, fantastic. Okay, well, we're going to spin the wheel now. Would you like us to start on any particular figure?
Number three.
Okay, number three. Why don't you pick something like 250 or something a bit higher? Oh, what a good idea. That's fantastic, John. All right. Now, do you want setup to spin fast, medium, or slow? All right, beautiful.
All right, I will spin it hard for you. Just bear with me. Got to do a wind up.
Whoa! Oh, it could be 2.5.
We've got $500.
Yeah. $500 going the way.
Going to Seaford Football Club.
Seaford Footy Club. That's magnificent. That's a night of beer.
Thank you very much.
Awesome. Well done. Congratulations. Back to you, Gareth.
Thank you, Sarah. They're nearly set here for the eighth race. I'm having my $50 on the hardstyle Rico for the Chirnside Park Football Club. So good luck to the boys there. Let's head to James for the eighth.
Bing. And they're all ready. Green light, set to go. Race eight, Sandown, about to run. Set. Racing, jumping well, Aston Silk from the centre, out fast, Leon Bale up to make the line of three, Shenlandino, and even wider, Short Pork and Security Codes driving hard the inside, followed by Hardstyle Rico, well back, Sipping Clive and Giggling Gertie can see the herd down the back straight. Going through, Short Pork had taken the lead, put up two lengths on Aston Silk. Thereby three lengths to Shenlandino and then Security Code, but Short Pork travelled boldly, put up four lengths on Aston Silk, and it's all Short Pork, a smart winner. Short Pork by three, beating Aston Silk, Shenlandino, and then Security Code, followed by Zipping Clive, Hardstyle Rico. He never came into play tonight, back with Leon Bale and Giggling Gertie last in, 29.35 the run.
Jealousy, turning saints into the sea, swimming through sick lullabies, choking on your alibis, but it's just the price I pay, destiny is calling me, open up my eager eyes, zombies to bright side.
Hey, Neil. The Downward Dogs, ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together. Well done, guys. The chair of the Sandown Greyhound Racing Club, Mr. Neil Brown, joins us now. G'day, Neil.
How are you, Gareth?
Good, thanks. Have you backed a winner tonight?
Oh, I have had a bit of success, but a three-legged quaddie, which is normal many, many times. But it's been a great concept tonight to do something new and... a different way of entertaining and bringing the Sandown Cup to a different audience. But in light of a very sad week, Gareth, for the greyhound industry here in Victoria, it'd be remiss of us not to mention the passing of Karen Leake, a great friend of everybody in the industry and certainly here at Sandown Park. I know that Karen had great delight in winning a Judy Haley Memorial on two occasions and was a wonderful trainer and conditioner of greyhounds and a much loved person. And yeah, it's a very sad week for everybody concerned, but we're going to bear it and get on with it, because I know Karen would like that. She helped a lot of people within the industry, and I served on the Hall of Fame committee with her for 10 or 12 years, and she was a great person.
And she was much loved in the industry. Talking to a few of the participants on my radio show today, she cared about the game, the sport of greyhound racing, and she helped a lot of the younger generation come through the ranks as well. And she was, the way that they were describing her to me, there was like, she was like the mother of the sport.
Absolutely. A much loved figure around the tracks where she raced, and certainly out this part of the world in the southern suburbs. She's been coming to Sandown for as long as I can remember. Certainly as long as I've been around the place, Judy, Karen was here in some respect. It's a very sad week for greyhound racing, but we'll always remember Karen Leake.
Yeah, her legacy will live on. Absolutely. And everybody in the greyhound industry, we're thinking of them, because they are going through some tough times at the moment.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Thanks, Karen.
Thanks, Neil. There's the chair of the Sandown Racing Club, Neil Brown. We're about to wrap it up shortly, Trev. I don't think the Punters Club did that great in the end.
Well, they should have listened to me and backed Short Pork.
Yeah. Why didn't they?
Exactly. See, you can stay up all night and do the form. You might just like the name anyway.
Hey, we might be still alive. We've got to ask Sarah and James when they get back to their spot that we could go again for race number nine, Daisy.
We may. Well, if we've got anything left, we may as well.
We'll just let it ride. We might go back to Sarah and Marty and see if we've got any money left in the Punters Club, Marty.
Well, money's not everything, you know, like you can't buy poverty.
No. We have $1,000 left.
Well, it's something.
In the Punters Club, and we will do the bets shortly. Large. We've just lost James, so we're trying to find where he is, but that's fine.
We'll probably
So Short Pork was the winner for race eight, which was fabulous. James is here.
James is about
Nothing to like live stream.
I've got to mention, Sarah, because I was playing and my tip, Hardstyle Rico, got held up in traffic a little bit. He didn't have the best of luck. So I apologise to the Churnside Park Football Club, but I was also playing for the Dandenong RSL Punters Club, the Auburn Bowls Club, and the Amasa St. Leo's Football Club. So they get to take home, or a hamper will be sent to them thanks to the Sandown Greyhound Racing Club, Trev.
And he'll be coming down to do a free appearance at all of those clubs just to make up for it.
And Trev will be coming with me, Marty, and so will you.
I'm there, mate. I'm all over it. Well, mate, welcome back. It's a long walk from the box. How did you go up there?
Yeah, mate, it's good for the fitness. So I'm just trying to work out where I can get this toupee that Trev was mentioning, because I won't have to worry about cutting my hair. I was thinking about it for the last 15 minutes.
No, I think someone else needs to worry about cutting your hair.
See, I gave you an out there. You could have gone, and toupee, $7.50.
Yes. Oh! Yay!
Yeah,
was that the word I was supposed to go with?
We should talk beforehand next time.
Yeah.
Oh. So we're looking for the inside mail on the next Punters Club.
Yes, I'm just having a chat to Joe walking down here, and he said, what do we go on? And we need to win money. It's all about winning money. And Joe, where has he gone? He's disappeared off set here. What have we done in the Punters Club, Joey? He looks stressed.
Come on screen, Joe.
Yeah, come out here, Joe.
Come out
come
here.
On. Come on.
Let's see the man behind the camera.
The lovely wife would love to see it. Your wife, not mine, I hope. All right, we're going to go to 2 and 4. What would that be? That would be the 4, which is Max Tractor and Shanlon Rob. We're having 500 on each to win. Wowee, we're going hard or going home here. 500 to win on the 2 and the 4, Marty.
Mate, and by the way, number 4, if it does get up, that's a $250 bonus to Victorian Police Fund, which is fantastic. Yes. On behalf of Greyhound Victoria. What a great initiative that is.
Yeah, mate, the GRV team are always really big on getting behind the community, and I think that's a prime example. We see the Great Chase is another great event. We've had the Go the Red Dog, Go the Pink Dog. There's been so many. And the Bendigo Greyhound Club, they actually do the Box 5 as well, I think, through June for the Give Me 5 for Kids. So it's great to see the greyhound racing community getting behind these people in need. And mate, I'm looking forward to racing over the next few weeks, because we've got the Grade 8 series, which is underway, and there'll either be an open class, free for all group class field every single week in greyhound racing for the next couple of months. It'll be here at Sandown and also at the Meadows. You'll get one a week. So Marty, really put that seatbelt on, mate. Batten down the hatches, because the next couple of months in greyhound racing is going to be great.
Well, let's hope number 4 gets up in this one, because it's paying 33s, and that'll only mean we're doing 1500. So what about this Punters Club? Sarah, your thoughts?
Yeah, sounds good.
Okay.
No, in all seriousness, though, on behalf of Sandown Greyhound Club, we'd like to thank everyone for tuning in. It's obviously a lot different during this time, so we really miss you all, and we hope to have you back here very soon. We'll have race 9 for you at 8:53, and in the meantime, just enjoy some music from our lovely band, Brandon from the Downward Dogs. Thanks for tuning in, guys.
Hope we can do it again on Box 9 Live.
Thank you so much, Gareth.
We'll be back probably for the Tab Melbourne Cup, hopefully. Daisy Thomas, you were superb all day, mate.
No, thank
and
you.
All night.
Thank you for having me, and hopefully we can do this with a few more people and have a couple of beers and find some winners next time.
Yep.
But thank we're you for having me. Great initiative, and thanks to everyone who tuned in at home.
Yep, and hopefully we can back a couple of winners at the end of the night with the 2 and the 4, Max Tractor and also Shanlon Rob, so God bless them. And Mr. Neil Brown, thank you very much for having us.
Been a pleasure, Gareth. Yep. It's been fantastic.
And let's hope we can get people back to the races shortly.
Soon as possible.
All right, mate. Let's play some music now as we say goodbye. The Downward Dogs. Sensational. Take it away.
Team. What a name, the Downward Dogs. Well, the truth, well, it hurts to say, I'm going to pack my bags and I'm going to go away. I'm going to split. I can't stand it. I'm going to get it up and quit it and never come it back. Woke up before I got to go and I got to say, I know you used to love me, but that was yesterday. Now the truth, I can't stand it. Gonna love starts burning where you got to do it right. Oh, lover, 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 you don't treat me no good no more. No good no more. Lover, treat me no good no more. Yeah. Now the truth, well, it hurts to say, I'm gonna pack my bags and I'm gonna go away. I'm gonna split.
I can't stand it. I'm gonna give it up and quit it and never coming back. Broke up before I got to go and I got to say, I know you used to love me, but that was yesterday. Now the truth, I can't stand it. When the love starts burning, well, you got to do it right. Oh, lover, 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 you don't treat me no good no more. Treat me no good no more.
Treat me good no more.
Yeah, lover, 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 you don't treat me no good no more. So no good no more. Lover, 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 you don't treat me no good no more. Yeah, well, lover, 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 you don't treat me no good no more. You don't treat me no good no more. Lover.
Well done, well done. Hey, we should put some requests out for the audience.
Give us some requests on Facebook.
If you're watching us on the Facebook page, make sure you send some requests in. And hopefully someone here will tell us what they are.
We're going to interact with you. Loving the streaming thing, yeah?
Woo!
Today was going to be the day that they're going to throw it back to you. By now, you should have somehow realized what you got to do. Yeah, hello at home. Back be the word is on the street that the fire in your heart is out. I'm sure you heard it all before, but you never really had a doubt. I don't believe that anybody feels the way I do about you now. Yeah, yeah. And all the roads we have to walk are winding. To lead us there were blinding. There are many things that I would like to say to you, but I don't know how. Everyone at home, I said maybe, you're gonna be the one that saves me. They'll never throw it back to you. By now, you should have somehow realized what you gotta do. I don't believe that anybody feels the way I do about you now. Hey, yeah. And all the roads we have to walk are winding.
I'll work it, work it. Yeah.
And all the lights that lead us there are blinding. Things that I would like to say to you, but I don't know how. Social distancing. Woo. 1.5 meters. Yeah. I said maybe. You're gonna be the one that saves me.
That saves me.
And after all, take your shoes off. Several. You're my wonderwall.
everyone at home listening. We are the Downward Dogs. Well, at least that's what we're called tonight. We're Brandon and Al. What a pleasure to be here, broadcasting live at Sandown Dogs. Thank you to Brendan and the crew here. They've been amazing.
Just checking to see if we've had any requests through, Brandon.
Yeah, hit us up with your requests on Facebook if anyone's still watching.
I need to see if we refresh.
Ooh.
No, nothing yet. Cool.
No, nothing. Okay, we're really going down well. This is awesome.
Maybe a bit of Georgie Ezra will get him requesting
stuff. I agree. Sounding good, Al.
You are.
As always, you are. Garden was blessed by the gods of me and you. We headed west, no, we'll find ourselves some true. What you waiting for? What you waiting for? We counted all our blessings, excuses that we made. We counted on some treasure and threw it all away. Oh, what you waiting for? What you waiting for? What you waiting for? What you waiting for? Yeah. When I dance alone and the sun's bleeding down, blame it on me. That we made, we confidence forgotten. I see the gypsies run. Oh, what you waiting for? What you waiting for?
Ah, Brandon, lots of close up.
Yeah. What you waiting for? What you waiting for? Handsome man.
Done.
Hang on, why don't we do the extended version of what we did earlier? We're just looking at ourselves on Facebook.
I'm just see if there's any requests here. I can't see any.
I think this is
Go the Dogs.
Go the Dogs. All right.
Yeah, let's do that.
For Shawn Mendes, for all those players at home. All right, Downward Dogs. I wanna follow where she goes. I think about her and she knows it. Cause every time that she gets close, I barely enter hesitation. She pulls me in enough to keep me guessing. Whoa, and maybe I should stop and start confessing. Confessing, yeah. I've been shaking, love it when you go crazy. Take all my inhibition, baby, there's nothing holding me back. You take my places, tear up my reputation, manipulate my decision, baby, there's nothing holding me back. Oh, no, 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 oh, no, no, baby, there's nothing holding me back. Oh, no, 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 oh, no, no. She says that she's never afraid. Just picture everybody naked.
Cause every time that she gets close, not really into hesitation, she pulls me in enough to keep me guessing. Whoa, and maybe I should stop and start confessing. Confessing, yeah. Oh, I've been shaking, I love it when you go crazy. Take all my inhibition, baby, there's nothing holding me back. You take my places, tear up my reputation, manipulate my decision, baby, there's nothing holding me back. Oh no, 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 oh no, no, baby, there's nothing holding me back. Oh no, 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 oh no, no, baby, there's nothing holding me back. Lost our minds, took it way too far, and know we'd be alright. We would be alright if you were by my side. Stumbled in the dark, I know we'd be alright. We would be alright, cause if we lost our minds, took it way too far, I know we'd be alright. We would be alright if you were by my side. Stumbled in the dark, I know we'd be alright. We would be alright. Oh, I've been shaking, I love it when you go crazy. Take all my inhibition, baby, there's nothing holding me back. You take my places, tear up my reputation, manipulate my decision, baby, there's nothing holding me back. The crowd goes wild out there online. Hang on, we got a request, have we?
We got a request. I saw a request come through. Better now, Brandon. I don't know if you know this.
Oh no, we better know it. Oh, this is you all over, mate.
A bit of wagon wheel. Oh, we love a bit of a wagon wheel.
Who's it for?
Hey, this is for the lovely Chanel.
Chanel, wherever you are.
Of the race. We might get half of this one in. Here we go.
Headed on south to the land of the pine. Strumming my way down to North Carolina. Staring at the road. Pretty God, I see headlights. I made it down the coast in 7 hours. Thinking me through Kentucky clouds. Hope for the rally. You see Jazzy tonight. Race. Al McInnes. Enjoy the next race.
Go to the next race.
It was a real sprinting performance the way he went about his business tonight. He was too good taking out the Sandown Cup here tonight. So they are about to be loaded now. Won't be too long before we see them loading up now. Race number 9. 2:10 about pure quality for those who took part in the Sandown Park Punters Club tonight with the live streaming, the Box 9 live streaming. Relying on a rough result, either Shanlon Robb or Max Tractor to spring an upset here. Both look chances in the race. And the favourite's been easy out to 2:15. And that is the red pure quality. Let's see what plays out. They're moving in now. So they are getting set for race number 9. Pure Quality 2:15. It'll run the fave. Son of Bastia Bale and Island's Force off the inside. Loading up now, the last line about to join them, Max Tractor and Shanlon Charlotte. And we will be set to see them run here, race number 9. Shanlon Robb probably has the speed to lead. Green light, set at Sandown, the RSN Central, ready to go.
away. Shantlin Rob pinged away from two. Straight out to lead, settling down over Chantel Rose. And there's Max Tractor getting into the action early. Followed by Shantlin Charlotte, about three lengths away. Run like Jess King Colt. Well back, Pure Quality with a lot to do. And last, Sevy Rose down the back. And Max Tractor, he powered up with the big wheels to take the lead and put up two lengths on Shantlin Rob. And they're clear to run like Jess. And Shantlin Charlotte, the punters club are cheering. Max Tractor turned the leader. He's off and gone. And Max Tractor won it easily by three lengths to run like Jess. Third, Shantlin Charlotte. And they were followed by Shantlin Rob, Chantel Rose, then King Colt, Pure Quality, Sevy Rose.
And that now, yeah? Well done to the punters club. So you're all going to get your money back. This is amazing. Excellent. All right, that's how we do it here at Sandown. Well done, punters club. Your money is back in your pocket.
Awesome. Now we're going to finish up with one more song to celebrate. You know what? You know what, Brandon? If with all this money, we could probably go to Cuba.
Ooh, yeah. I like that. Down with dogs. Lining
down with
it up.
Dogs.
I'm tired of the city. Summer's on the run. People tell me I should stay.
Look at the clothes.
But I got to give a son.
That's close up.
So don't try to hold me back. There's nothing you can say. Snake eyes on the paradise. And we got to go today. Take me to the April sun in Cuba. Whoa. Take me where the April sun gonna treat me so right, so right, yeah, so right. I can almost smell the perfume of light and see the starry sky. I wish you're coming with me, baby. Cause right before my eye, I see. Catch you in the LA way. Talking about miss out love. Talking about a JFK and the way he shook things up. Take me to the April sun in Cuba. Tired of the city life. Summer's on the run. Birds in the winter sky, heading for the sun. Oh, we can stick it out in this cold and gray. Snake eyes on the paradise. And we got to go today. Take me to the April sun in Cuba.
See you later, guys.
Woo! Dabba dogs.